The Hypex DIY ClassD Streaming preamp comes in easy to build parts with the build quality of a factory product. But how does it sound? Manufacturing mainstream electronic equipment can be done efficiently. That's the power of large-scale production. For specialist equipment, components insertion and soldering on circuit boards can be done, but assembling often still is done manually. This Hypex kit contains finished product circuit boards, all cabling and hardware, and leaves assembling to the buyer. The savings obtained might be clear, not only on labor, but also on the taxes on labor, import taxes, sales channel margins and sales tax, like the VAT in Europe. So if you can operate a screwdriver and have built IKEA or Lego products in the past, there is money to be made. A step-by-step manual guides you through the assembly. There are two levels, the analog preamp and the analog preamp plus DAC. The DAC kit comes with cables and hardware to fit a Raspberry Pi, but you have to buy the Pi yourself. The version on review here has the DAC kit and a Raspberry Pi 5 on board. The Pi in the review sample runs Rupee software. I have not built it myself, but was interested in the features and the sound quality. So Hypex sent me one of their already built demo models. So let's start showing where it is to be used in your stereo. In this video, I will call the Hypex DIY ClassD Streaming preamp simply the Hypex. The Hypex can be connected to an integrated amplifier over XLR cables or XLR to RCA cables, depending on the amp used. Of course, the amp has to be connected to a pair of loudspeakers or headphones. The Hypex also need to be connected to your router to be able to stream from sources on the internet and, if wanted, stream from your computer or NAS. The computer or NAS must run a music server program like Rune, DLNA server, LMS, or Ivana or the like. That music server program is usually controlled using an app on a smartphone or tablet. If you still want to play CDs as well, the CD can be connected digitally over speaker for Toslink or analog using a pair of XLR or RCA cables. The sound of your TV can be connected over either Toslink optical cable or analog over a pair of RCA cables or a 3.5mm jack to RCA cable depending on your TV. Another analog source like a tuner can be connected too. Instead of an integrated amplifier, a power amplifier might even be more appropriate. Using a 3.5mm to 3.5mm jack cable between the trigger output on the Hypex and the trigger input on the power amplifier switches on the power amp when the Hypex is switched on. There are two pairs of trigger outputs on the Hypex for if you use two or four mono amps. Active loudspeakers, the ones with built-in amplifiers, can be connected instead. It's even possible to use both, since the Hypex has two pairs of outputs, each with trigger outputs. A more obvious use of the two pairs of outputs is bi-amping, where one stereo power amp or two mono power amps is used to drive the woofers and a second stereo amp or two mono amps is used for the mid and high drivers. The sturdy full metal housing doesn't look like a DIY project. It measures 415 by 276 by 77 mm and weighs 4.2 kilos. On the front left we see the DIY ClassD logo. On the Dutch Audio Event 2024, Hypex introduced faceplates for all their kits in both silver and black and without the DIY ClassD logo. It's good to point out that this is the brand name. The preamp does not use ClassD amplifier techniques. It's in Class A. The left rotary encoder lets you select the inputs and operate the menu. The infrared eye here receives the infrared signals from the included remote control. The display normally shows the chosen input and output, but in menu mode it shows the menu options. Below it is the power LED. The right rotary encoder sets the volume, when pressed activates mute, and when pressed longer it activates standby. There are two different headphone outputs, balanced on XLR4 and non-balanced on 6.3mm jack. The headphone outputs are activated with this small button. An LED above it lights up when activated. Power is connected to the IEC mains inlet on the right. Above it is the power switch. That is normally not operated, for you will use standby from the front. Then we get the digital inputs, provided you bought the so-called pre-dig-in option. AES-EBU, network, USB-B, Toslink optical and SPDIF coax. The fusion connections are for use with an external DSP unit. Then we get the analog inputs. Input 1 on RCA, input 2 on RCA and input 3 on XLR. There are two sets of balanced outputs, each with trigger outputs. Balanced output 1 left and right, two trigger outputs, and balanced output 2 again with two trigger outputs. A mini USB port is for updates and configuration only. This is done in a Windows app that can be downloaded from the DIYClassD.com website. It's quite simple to remove the top lid by removing the front, but to have a better lighting for the photo I removed the sides as well. And this is what you see then. The switch mode power supply is in the lower left of this photo. Hypex knows how to build switch mode power supplies, just like Grim Audio, Lin and for instance Meridian. Switch mode power supplies get a bad name from cheap wallboard and power brick versions. The analog preamp is situated against the rear so that all input connectors are mounted directly on the circuit board. Since the preamp is microprocessor controlled, there are banks of relays. The black squares along the lower end function as audio connectors to other boards, like the headphone board, the DAC board and the not yet released phono preamp board. The pre-dig-in extension is found here. The lower circuit board handles the digital inputs. This board does the interfacing for the digital insert points that can be used for outboard sound processing. It also has an Asahi Kasei AK5574 analog to digital converter aboard so that analog signals can also benefit from the processing if wanted. The third board is the digital to analog converter. It uses two Cirrus CS43198 DAC chips, one per channel and used in differential mode. It has four filter settings. Fast low latency, which is great if you want to use the Hypex for TV and video sound. Fast linear, slow linear and non-oversampling. The latter I enjoyed most. Finally, the Raspberry Pi is found here. As you can see, it's connected to the digital I/O board for power with the wide USB-C cable. This of course means that it enjoys a high quality power supply. For audio, the connection to the pre-dig-in board is over a USB-A to USB-B cable. The Ethernet connection again is connected to the pre-dig-in board over a short network cable. As a preamp it works quite simple. Connect the sources and the amplifier or active speakers to the Hypex. Then the power cable and flip the power switch. Pressing the volume knob will start it up. Then using the left knob select the input, make sure the amp is on and on the right input and you're ready to play music. Want to listen to headphones? Just plug them in and press the small button next to the headphones output and you're ready. Happy days! Using the menu you can set all kinds of preferences, like if you want an input sent out unaltered volume. This creates a processor pass-through so you can use the stereo as left and right channel in a surround setup. There can be a gain offset, trigger settings, an input name change, so for instance TV instead of input 2 and so on. The display can be set to two brightnesses, to a time to switch off and the power LED can be dimmed. I already mentioned the four reconstruction filters that can be chosen. For streaming you need to buy a Raspberry Pi yourself, install the software and connect it to the pre-digging board. All cabling is supplied and connected to the lower board of the pre-digging kit. Since the audio goes over USB, it will be a standard audio class 2 connection. So if you want to use another small board computer, that is possible too. As is any choice of software player supporting audio class 2. As far as I know, they all do. I would go for the Raspberry Pi 5 with 4GB and installed Gentoo player. See my Raspberry Pi for music video. But again, you're free to choose what you want. As said, the review sample had a Pi 5 with Ruby installed, meaning that it can be used as renderer for DLNA, UPnP AV, AirPlay, Spotify Connect, Squeezebox, HQ Player NAA, Plex Amp and Rune. Unfortunately, the volume can't be controlled over the remote amp. I've tried Apple AirPlay, Rune over Rad and Audivana and they all functioned well but had no volume control in the remote control app. Soundwise, I heard no difference between Rune and Audivana. Apple AirPlay was slightly limited. Since my Magna Manup got lost in transport during an update, I was not able to reliably test the digital inputs. So I only tested the streaming functions with the aforementioned network player software. I used the non-oversampling setting. The analog inputs were listened to using an analog XLR output of the Grimmute 2 streamer as source. I did this in the following setup. The analog outputs of the Hypex were connected to the Air Acoustics AX520 amplifier on OVA EQ feed over Grim Audio SQM XLR cables. I've both tried using the Air as integrated amp and in processor pass-through mode, in which it functions as a power amp. The PMC Effect 12 signature loudspeakers on Stack Audio OVA 17 isolators were connected over AudioQuest Robinhood Zero loudspeaker cable. The connection between the Hypex and the Zixel GS1900-10HP switch was over a Network Acoustics Eno 2 system Ethernet filter. Access to the internet was over a Ziggo business modem that is connected to the Zixel over a Cat6 patch cable. Also connected to the Zixel is the Sonic Transporter i7 CDR that runs Minim server and Rune server. An iPad 2 was used to control Minim server over the Glider app and Rune and Audivana over their respective remote apps. The Grim Audio Mute 2 as analog source was connected over Grim Audio SQM XLR cables to the Hypex and over Cat6 cable to the Zixel switch. All equipment was placed in a Creative Trend 3-3 rack. Offering a digital signal, the Hypex is able to project a fine stereo image with proper focus, rather black background and air around the instruments. The low end and highs have good resolution. The resolution of the mid-range is clearly above average. The sound is rather stress-free and sibilance is controlled very well. As an analog preamp, it is impressive too. The difference between the direct output of the Grim player and through the Hypex is relatively small, all in relation to the price of course. I scale it in slightly above mid-setup 1B. There are also two future updates announced, a phono stage and an equalizer. I presume the equalizer will be connected to the Fusion Connect plugs on the rear. The phono input is already on the analog board. Expect settings to be done in a Windows app. The analog kit retails for €1,482, the pre-digging digital add-on at €932, and a Raspberry Pi with 4GB of RAM costing €66, that adds up to €2,414, including 21% VAT. That's slightly over €2,000 for those that live outside the EU and pay no VAT. But be sure to add your local sales tax and shipping. Building the Hypex doesn't require a degree in electronics. If you manage to correctly assemble IKEA furniture, you can do this too. Just be methodical. Assembling the Hypex brings you a streaming DAC with preamp comparable to a ready-to-use product costing 500 to 700 euros more. Coming from the house that also produces Mola Mola, it's a very good sounding product for the money. Next week I will review the matching DIY ClassD Nilay mono power amplifiers. And on that bombshell, we come to the end of this video. There will be a new video next week, so subscribe to this channel or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn or Instagram to stay informed on when new videos are out. Help me reach even more people by giving this video thumbs up or link to this video on the social media. It is much appreciated. Many thanks to those viewers that support this channel financially. It keeps me independent and lets me improve the channel further. If that makes you feel like supporting my work too, the links are in the comments below this video on YouTube. I'm Hans Beekhuizen, thank you for watching and see you next week. And whatever you do, enjoy the music. And whatever you do.